Bright Tales is a cooperative and semi-cooperative game for 1 to 4 players, in which you take over the roles of brave knights, who for 3 days and 3 nights have to defend a remote village against the hordes of darkness. During the day, you supply yourselves with useful weapons, armor, artifacts, allies, and animal companions. And during the night, you hold the village's defenses against minions, champions, and a mighty boss. But beware, as should you survive all 3 nights, then only 1 player can be the true champion about whom future tales will be told. Night Tales is played on a special game mat, which is divided into a night and a day side. Before you start playing, you have to roll out the mat, assemble the 3D elements which are included in the game, and place them on their designated spots. All components shown in this video are prototypes, which means that they can and will change compared to the final product. Next, you place the gold pieces near the game board, as well as the game tokens. The wall with the marketplace is placed on the day side, and the wall with the dark forest on the night side. Shuffle the market deck and place 9 cards face down on the designated spaces. Place the rest of the cards near the market. In addition, there are 3 trophy cards, which can be identified by their special card backs. Place them at the head of the day side. The monster cards have to be split into 2 decks, one with all minion monsters and one with all champions. The monsters can be differentiated by the symbols on their cards. Minions have a skull symbol with 1 sword and a gray symbol at the top left. Champions have 2 swords and a gold symbol. The boss cards are placed beside the monster cards. Next, you ready the quest cards, sorted by the numbers printed on them. Make sure that the card sides with difficulty, easy to hard, is face up. Do the same with the valor cards. Next, you can determine who of you plays which knight. You can either agree on 1 knight or randomize. Each knight has his or her own special ability. Other than that, they play identical. On the backside of each card, you can find the long sword. This is your starting item, and you can place it next to your knight board, which you should now also make ready. Each knight also has a set of his own crest tokens. They are used to mark used abilities and items, damage on monsters, and completed tasks. Next, you place fatigue, life, and wrath markers. The red fatigue marker is placed below the number which is equal to the number of players. The green marker is placed next to the drop, and the wrath marker is placed based on the position during the day. Every player also gets gold based on the number of players. 8 for 2 players, 6 for 3 players, and 5 for 4 players. The game always begins with the first day phase. The players place their knight miniatures on their spots next to the marketplace. On the first day, the order for this is determined by the chosen knight. It is printed on the lower right of the knight board. The position on the day side always determines how many wrath points a player has at the beginning of the knight phase. This is also marked on the game mat. The player on position 1 gets no wrath points, while the player on position 4 gets 3. If you play with less than 4 players, then simply skip the lowest positions. In a 2-player match, for example, only position 3 and 4 would be taken. The first step during each day is the revealing of the corresponding quest card. These are tasks which the players can complete during the night to collect additional victory points. How many victory points you get is determined by the position in which you complete the quest. Whoever completes it first gets the most points. A quest remains active throughout the whole game, but each player can only complete it once. If all 3 spots are taken, then the 4th player, if existing, is out of luck. Now you can reveal all market cards to see what's on offer right now. Then the players, one after another, can spend their gold pieces to buy items. Always only 1 item at once, and the order is determined by the current position of the knights. When it's a player's turn, He just takes the chosen card and pays its cost in gold pieces. Then he can place it next to his knight board. The space on the marketplace, which is now free, is filled based on the chosen difficulty. On the easy difficulty, a new market card immediately is revealed. On the medium difficulty, a card is placed with the face down and is revealed at the start of the next day. And on the hardest difficulty, the market is only refreshed when all revealed items are bought. Contrary to the other items, the trophy cards cannot be bought with gold, but by spending monster cards, which are collected during the night phase. On each trophy card is printed how many and what type of monster has to be spent in order to buy it. As soon as it's a player's turn, and he can't or doesn't want to spend any more gold, his day phase is finished, his miniature is removed and placed on the night side. The position for this is always determined by the order in which the players ended their day phase. As soon as all players are done shopping and are placed on the night side, the day ends and the night begins. Each of the three knights has its own valor card. On its backside is printed how many minions and champions are placed on the field based on the chosen difficulty. On the other side of the card are three color-coded areas with victory points. Based on which position the life point marker of a player is located at the end of the night, he gets more or less victory points. You now randomly assemble a deck of 9 cards with a number of champions and minions based on the difficulty setting and place them on the field with their faces down. Next, the front row of cards is revealed. All monsters which have the moves to back rule are moved into the backmost possible row, and the rest of the monster cards are moved one row to the front. The card which is now in the front row is also revealed. A monster card which is moved to the front row is always revealed. Monsters with the moves to back rule often have special abilities, which allow them to strengthen monsters which are below them and in the same lane. Monsters with a rank effect have similar strengthening abilities for monsters in the same row as themselves. You can use the included game tokens to mark the effects of these abilities. Should a monster which is the source of an effect be removed from the game, then the effect is immediately also removed from all other monsters in the game. As soon as all monsters are organized on the battlefield, place a gold piece on each life point symbol on each monster card. Then you can reveal the boss for this night. Shuffle the boss deck and reveal the top card. Grab the corresponding boss board and place it at the head of the knight side. Then place the Doom Tracker on the first slot of the boss board. The Doom Tracker is a small token with a skull on it. Each boss has his or her own tactics deck. Place it next to the boss card. Make sure to place it in a way that the top card is face up and readable. Now everything is prepared and the battle can begin. Your goal during the night is to defeat all monsters as well as the boss. The night ends when there are no more enemies on the field or when all knights have been defeated. One after another, based on their position, the knights now each attack one monster. All revealed monsters in the first, second and third row can be targeted. To attack a monster in the first row costs 1 fatigue point. To attack a monster in the second row costs 2 points and an attack in the third row costs 3 points. This cost can be increased by monster abilities. When the target is selected, the dice pool is assembled. A knight always has 3 dice by default. The color and number of monster dice is printed on their card. There are red and yellow monster dice. The following dice results are possible in Knight Tales. The sword inflicts 1 point of damage and is present on all dice. The double sword counts as 2 sword symbols. It is present on the blue and red dice. The shield symbol can be used to negate 1 sword symbol. It is included on all monster and knight dice. The faith symbol is only available to knight dice. It can be used to remove a whole enemy die. The doom symbol is only present on the red and yellow monster dice, and it moves the doom tracker on the boss board one step further. The yellow monster dice also have a blank side, which does nothing. As soon as all necessary dice are assembled, the attacking player rolls them all at once. The knight dice as well as the monster dice. And then the dice results are compared. Each shield result removes one enemy sword symbol. So it either negates one die with a single sword result, or it halves the sword value of a double sword result. The faith symbol allows for the removal of any enemy die. All swords which were not removed by shields of the monster are subtracted from the life points of the monster. The attacking player takes a gold piece for each inflicted point of damage and places an equal number of crest tokens. Should the attacking player inflict damage equal to or more than the life points of the monster, then it is defeated and the player can take the monster card, but only if he has caused more damage than each other player. As long as there are still monster cards behind the defeated monster, they are moved forward and cards in the front row are revealed. If a player does not manage to block all damage caused by a monster, then it is subtracted from his life points. By moving the life marker, the player now also has more wrath points at his disposal. Should at any point life point marker and fatigue marker meet, then the knight is defeated and cannot fight on. Should this happen before an attack is conducted, for example because the fatigue marker was moved for the action, then the attack may be completed before the knight is defeated. A defeated knight is removed from the knight side and placed on the day side. The first removed player of the knight is placed on the last position of the day side. The second on the third position and so on. The player now immediately places a crest token on the area of the valor card which corresponds to the current position of his life point marker. Players can use items, abilities and wrath points to manipulate the result of the combat roll. Items and abilities work in the same way. They can be used only once per knight. Items with a fist symbol have to be used prior to a combat roll. Items and abilities with a lightning symbol can be used after the dice are rolled. Each knight has his own knight ability, which can also only be used once per knight. After a dice roll, knights can also use their wrath points. Using two wrath points allows you to roll an additional knight die. However, a knight can never roll more than four blue dice. Using a single wrath point allows you to re-roll a single knight die. You can do this as often as you like, as long as you have wrath points to spend. You can also re-roll the same die multiple times. As soon as the last row has been freed up by advancing monsters, the boss advances into the first row. From this point on, he can be attacked like any other monster. Each boss in Night Tales has a so-called movement tactic, which is triggered when he or she moves one row to the front. In the base game, the bosses use this to cause lane damage in lanes which have a specific kind of monster. The possible monster types in the base game are Orc, Undead and Beast. Please be aware that movement tactics are triggered before moved monster cards are revealed. This is to prevent nasty surprises which would cause unpreventable lane damage. For each doom result, which is not prevented by the player doing a combat roll, the doom tracker on the boss board is moved by one step. This can make the boss stronger by giving him additional dice or automatic shield results. If the doom tracker moves on a slot with a skull symbol, then the top card of the tactics deck of the boss is triggered. Do what the card reads and then move it to the bottom of the deck so that the next card is visible. Lane damage, which beside the movement tactic of the bosses, can also be caused by other boss tactics and monster abilities, does not hit the knights, but the defensive structures of the village. Each lane has 3 health points, which are represented by 3 palisades. Should a lane lose all 3 palisades, then all further damage goes directly towards the village, which has 3 health points represented by the buildings. If all buildings are destroyed, then the village has fallen and all players have lost. Should at any point during the night all players have been defeated, then all monsters remaining on the field do lane damage before they retreat and the night is ended. Every minion monster does 1 point of damage in its lane. Every champion causes 2 points of damage in its lane. And the boss causes 1 point of lane damage in each lane. Attacking the boss works as with every other monster in the game. You spend fatigue points based on the current position of the boss. You assemble combat dice based on the current position of the Doom Tracker. And hopefully you cause some damage, which as with other monsters gives you gold, and which you should mark with your crest tokens. If the boss is defeated, his boss board is removed from the field, and the player who inflicted the most damage can claim the boss card. If there are still monsters on the field, they have to be defeated, otherwise the player whose last turn it was is placed on the next position on the day side, followed by the next player, and so on. Again, an earlier switch to the day side means a later position during shopping. All players who have not already done so now place their crest tokens on the area of the Valor card, which corresponds to the current position of their life point marker. There's no limit as to how many tokens can be in one area. With the dawn of the new day, all fatigue and health markers are returned to their starting positions, all crests are removed from abilities and items, and the Wrath marker is placed based on the current position on the day side. If you are playing on the medium difficulty, you can now reveal all face down market cards. Now you can flip a new quest card, buy additional items, and face the hordes of evil for 2 additional nights. Should you survive the 3rd night, then it is determined based on the collected victory points who fought the bravest. The exact scoring lists are printed in the Night Tales rulebook. But to keep it short, you get points for the monsters you collected and did not spend. You get bonus points based on how many different kinds of monsters you collected. Champions and bosses are their own types. You get points for the items you bought on the market. And bonus points for the number of different kinds of items you bought. You get points for the gold pieces you have remaining. And for your positions on the quest and valor cards. I hope that you are now feeling like telling your own tale. Have fun with Night Tales.